Hi, this is Shrink Siddharth and welcome to another video on Kotlin programming. Now in Kotlin, we have slightly different way to compare two objects or two values when compared to languages like Java. So in this video, I will show you how you can compare two values in Kotlin and how you can compare two object references in Kotlin using the concept of structural and referential equality in Kotlin. So before we start this video, if you are new, please subscribe to my channel and give this video a big thumbs up. So let's get started. The structural equality in Kotlin is represented by two equal to operator. Well, it basically uses the equals method to compare two objects only in terms of its values. So please note that we only compare values using this operator. For example, if you use 10 equal to 20, then it actually compares the two values using the equals method. So this expression will return false as they are not equal. Now please note that this operator is totally different when compared to the equal to operator in Java. In Java, this equal to operator is used to compare two object instances. But in Kotlin, it is being used to compare just the values and nothing else. So this is what is structural equality operator in Kotlin. Next is referential equality, which is represented by 3 equal to symbol. So in Kotlin, this operator is used to check if two reference variables point to the same object or not. For example, you can use u1, which is a reference variable, then referential equality operator, then another object u2. So this expression will check if u1 and u2 reference variables point to the same object or not. If they point to the same object, like in this case, then this expression will return true. Otherwise, it will return false. Nice and simple. So in case of referential equality, we don't worry about the value of this object. We just need to know that these two variables point to the same object or not, and nothing else. So let us understand them using examples. Now, we already know that we have something called heap memory, where the objects are actually stored. And we have a stack memory, where we store the reference variables. So suppose we have a user class with some properties and we create two user objects. So this statement, let us assume, will create user1 object and this statement will create user2 object. So this user1 and user2 object will be created within the heap memory like this. And their reference variables u1 and u2 will be stored in the stack memory. And of course, they will point to their own objects. Now, if you compare u1 and u2 by using structural equality operator, then this means we are comparing the value of u1 and u2. So the value of u1 is user1 object, and the value of u2 is the user2 object. So internally, it means this statement using equals method. Now, since both the values are different, of course, so we get false in the output. Fine, that is, both object values are not same. Now, if you compare them referentially, then it is quite clear from what we saw over here that both u1 and u2 points to the different objects. So here as well, we will get false. Because u1 and u2 both points to their own objects, that is different objects. Fine. So I hope you got an idea of what these two operators actually means and their usage. Next, suppose we create another object. Let's call it user3 this time. So visually in stack memory, we will have a reference variable of u3. Pointing to another object user3. Next, we used u4 equal to u3. So this statement will make u4 point to the same object as it was being done by u3. Right, that is the user3 object. So here we get u4 pointing to the same object user3. So now you can guess the output of these two statements. So just pause the video and think about the output. So this expression will be true, because we are comparing user3 with user3 object itself, which is of course true. Next, this expression will again return true, because both u3 and u4 point to the same object. Fine, which is clearly visible over here. Now, moving on, let's see an example in case of strings. Now, in case of strings, things are slightly different. Strings are stored in a place known as string constant pool, present within the heap memory. So, when this statement is executed, then it creates str1, which points to string hello stored within this pool. Next, when this statement is executed, then it is found by a Java virtual machine or the JVM that, hey, we already have this hello string within the pool. So let's save some resource and memory and make this str2 point to the same object string hello. So in the stack, we will get str2 pointing to the same hello string already present in the pool. So this way JVM saves some memory, right? Then we have str3, which has a different string value. So this will create a different value in the pool like this. So looking at this visual itself, now you can easily predict the output of these print statements. So this statement is str1 equal to str3. Well, this will be false, because their values are different. Then comparing the value of str1 and str2, this will be true, as their string values are same. Then comes referential equality. So this statement will be true, because str1 and str2 are both pointing to the same object, which you can visually see over here. Pretty simple. Next, we have str1 and str3 reference comparison, which will be false, of course, because they point to different objects. Now, similar to strings, the same principle is applicable for integers, float values, byte values, and so on. For example, in case of these integers, this num1 and num2 are both 10, and this num3 is 20. So, num1 and num2 will point to one object with value of 10. And of course, num3 will refer to 20. So looking at this, this value comparison will be true, of course, no doubt here, because num1 and num2 are same with equal value. And when we compare the references, then also this will be true, as num1 and num2 points to the same object, right? So I hope things are pretty clear in your mind. Now, moving on to the last part of this video. What's the opposite of these two operators? That is, their negated counterpart. So for structural equality, the negated counterpart is not equal to operator. I am sure you are familiar with this operator. So in your code, you either use this or this to compare the two values. Fine, so nothing new here. Similarly, for referential equality, the negated counterpart is the not operator followed by two equal to symbols. So in your code, you either use this or this to compare the two references. Fine. So using structural equality and referential equality might be a little tricky to use in your project if you don't know about it. But after watching this video, I am sure you know a lot about them and how to use them in your project. So in the end, if you found this video helpful, then give this video a big thumbs up. And to support this video, please comment below the video. This will help me a lot to grow. So this is Shreyansh Siddharth signing off. Thanks for watching and have a great day. Bye.